Hello friends, now we are going to learn about the new chapter, that is chapter number 9, and which is on dividend decisions. So far if you see, we have learned about in other chapters from chapter 1 to chapter 10, except for chapter 9 we have covered all chapters. Now in all other chapters we have covered everything about the capital, then everything about the liabilities, everything about the fixed assets or non-current assets, and also on the current assets. Okay, so we had covered the capital structure theories, then capital, how to take decisions with respect to debt equity mix, then we have also learned about working capital. So once all those things are over, now this chapter is a peculiar chapter where we are focusing on the dividend decisions. Okay, dividend decisions means how a company have to decide how much dividend should be paid by it to the investors. Now this is also very crucial, because payment of dividend is nothing but the return to the equity shareholders. So a company have to decide whether or not to pay dividend, and if they choose to pay the dividend, how much dividend it needs to pay to the equity shareholders. Okay, right. Now let's straight away start with the topics, and as the previous chapters, here also I'm going in the same order as that of institute material, so that it will be easy for you to follow, okay, when it comes to the study material. Okay, now the first small concept which we are going to see is the relationship between retained earnings and the growth. Now friends, this is something which we have already learned when we learned about the capital asset pricing model. Okay, or we have learned about the Gordon's model. All those things we have learned. Now where, what is this relationship between retained earnings and growth? Okay, now the growth of an entity is denoted as G. G is equal to B into R. So what is B? B is the retention ratio. Retention ratio. What is retention ratio? Retention ratio is nothing but 100% minus dividend payout ratio. Dividend payout ratio. So if the company earns, let's say, 100 rupees as profits and it pays 20 rupees as dividend, then it retains 80 rupees as the retained earnings. So what is the ratio or proportion of the profits which is retained as retained earnings by the company? That is what is given by retention ratio. Okay, now what is R? R is nothing but the rate of return on investment. Okay, so if you see the principle behind this formula, okay, whatever retained earnings the company is making or is company is having, okay, those retained earnings are reinvested in the business to generate a return of R percentage. Okay, so the growth rate the company is having is only on account of the retained earnings. Suppose there is no retained earnings or whatever profit the company is making, the entire profits are declared and paid as dividend, and there is no retained earnings, then there will not be any increase in the capital. Whatever capital was there at the beginning of the year, the same capital will be there at the end of the year, because whatever profit is generated, it was paid as a dividend. Okay, so capital at the opening and closing remains same. So if that is the case, the profit that the company will make in the current year as well as the next year, that is also will be same, because the capital is same. So unless there is any increase in the capital, the profit made by a company should remain same in the previous year as well as the current year, because the return on capital employed will be same. But if there is a difference, or if there is any retained earnings, or if the entire profits are not distributed, okay, what will happen? The closing capital will be obviously higher than the opening capital. Okay, and since the closing capital is higher, when you apply the return on capital employed on the closing capital, that return on capital employed which you generated for the next year will be higher than the return on capital employed which you have generated in the previous year, or the profits that you have generated in the previous year. So it is from a common man's perspective, you can say that the growth in a company is only on account of the retained earnings. Okay, so that is why we are having this formula G is equal to B into R, where B is the retention ratio and R is the return on capital employed. Now, to make it a little more clear, suppose there is a company and the company has a retention ratio of 60% and it has a return on capital of 20%, then G is equal to B into R, that is 60% into 20%, and 60% into 20% is nothing but 12%. So the growth rate will be 12%. Okay, so that is this formula. This is a very small formula. You just keep that in your mind. We have already learned it in another chapter, and we have not written a note on that also. So I am not giving you any more note on this. Okay, so that is sorry, the relationship between retained earnings and the growth. Now coming to the next, theories of dividend. Now, what is theories of dividend? Now, we have already learned something about capital structure theories. Capital structure theory. And what was this capital structure theories? The capital structure theory mainly focused on whether the debt equity mix or debt equity pattern is relevant to the value of the firm. Okay, so whether the value of the firm is affected when you have a definite debt or equity, or when there is a change in debt equity pattern. That is what in capital structure theories. But now when you come to the theories of dividend, what these theories say, these theories evaluate what is the impact of dividend payout on the value of the firm. So in capital structure, it was the impact of debt equity mix, whereas in dividend theories, it is the dividend ratio or dividend payment ratio. Are you paying the entire dividend, or are you paying 50-50 or 60-40, or are you not paying any dividend at all? What is that impact of dividend payout ratio on your value of the firm? That is what is known as theories of dividend. And like in the case of capital structure theories, you might be knowing about the different theories. We had two types of theory, dividend relevant, I mean, in capital structure, you had relevance theory as well as irrelevance theory. Similarly, in theories of dividend also, you have relevance theory as well as irrelevance theory. Under relevance theory, you have two models. One is Walter's model and the other one is Gordon's model. And in irrelevance theory, you have approach or Modigliani-Miller approach. We have already learned about this approach or Modigliani-Miller approach in another in the previous chapter. Okay, so we are going to learn about three theories in this chapter. One is approach or Modigliani-Miller approach, then Walter's model, then Gordon's model. Okay, now we will take these models one by one.